Hello, welcome to this Microsoft Virtual Academy session. Today we're going to be looking at user and device management using System Center Configuration Manager and Windows Intune. My name is Martin Booth. I'm a senior technical product manager. I look specifically after the user and device management scenarios. And with me is Wally Mead.
Thank you, Martin. Welcome. My name is Wally Mead. I'm a senior program manager in the engineering team for the enterprise client management team that is producing these two different products that Martin's going to talk about today.
Okay, thank you. So I've got a few slides that I'm going to go through that just talk about what people-centric IT is and where the products fit within that. And then we're going to get into some demos and actually see the products in action. Today's challenges really stem from what the users need to do. People are out there, they want to be productive, they want to get access to their work information wherever they are and whatever they're doing. And of course, there are a multitude of device types out there. Many people are getting devices and want to bring them in and use them for work purposes and get access to things through corporate IT. But these may not be part of the standard set of devices that IT is used to supporting. And of course, we have all the applications that people want access to, not just their personal applications from the public application stores, but also their corporate applications. And getting access to those across this variety of platforms and devices can be a real challenge for IT to manage. And then, of course, we have the data side of things. It's great if people want to bring in these devices to help make them more productive, but how does a company ensure that these devices are secured and that data is being looked after on them in the most appropriate manner possible? So we start with this idea of people-centric IT, and that's taking those four areas and seeing how we can address these in a manageable way, in a way that access is controlled, maintained, and we have the protection that IT needs to provide around the corporate data there. And there are three real areas we look at. Enabling the users, allowing this choice of access to devices and applications. Unifying the environment. We don't want to spawn off multiple different solutions and systems for every device type that comes in here. So how do we bring these devices into the environment that IT has for managing their existing on-premise devices? And then, of course, protecting the data, making sure this corporate information is not put at risk. In terms of the first pillar, enabling the users, I mentioned this choice of devices and the access to corporate applications and the control of information that IT needs to provide around that. So the answer for that is really enabling people to take their devices, register them with the corporate network so they become a known trusted device for the enterprise, enrolling the devices for management so that we can ensure the devices have a consistent set of policy and the right controls on them to make sure the data is secured, and also IT having the ability to publish applications and access to information in the way that's most appropriate for the user of that device. In terms of unifying your environment, we don't want solutions that do not integrate. We want to be able to provide a solution for managing these devices that brings them into the same world as on-premise PC management as well. And the other side of it is the identity side, making sure that we enable people to have identity, which is consistent whether they're accessing cloud resources or on-premise resources. For IT, this is really about having this single pane of glass view. If we're managing our devices and our PCs, we want to do it through one familiar process, through one tool, through one administration console. And then the final pillar was around protecting your data. So making sure that any access to information is through an appropriate means, whether it's a web application or a virtualized version of the application, so data's not actually landing on the device, or whether it's deploying a full native application down to the device with maybe some control around data like rights management capabilities or work folders, synchronization of data. So we really look at providing those tools that enable us to protect the data, unify the environment, and give the users the tools they need. So that was a brief overview of what people-centric IT means to us. And the Microsoft approach to this is to take System Center Configuration Manager, the predominant enterprise client management solution, and extend it out to the devices. So we're going to look now at kind of what this means, and Wally here is going to take us through some examples, some demos of how this gets set up within Configuration Manager and what we can do on the devices themselves. So let's head over to the demos. And Wally, can you show us kind of where this sits within Configuration Manager and how we set it up?
That I can do. Thank you, Martin. And with that great introduction, so what we have in our environment, what most of the customers are going to have is the on-premise solution that Martin talked about being Configuration Manager. And we want to manage these mobile devices, which is done through the cloud service, Windows Intune. And as he mentioned, we want to have a single pane of glass, a single management infrastructure to manage both your on-premise Windows devices, as well as your Macs and your Linux, Unix devices, and your mobile devices that your end users are bringing into the workplace today. So we have here the Configuration Manager Administrator console, which is going to be that single pane of glass to integrate the two resources together. So the first thing you would do is you would configure the integration between Windows Intune and Configuration Manager. So in the console, in the administration workspace, you would go to this new node we have in Configuration Manager 2012 R2 called Cloud Services. You'd expand that folder, and you'd see here the top node is Windows Intune Subscriptions. So the Windows Intune subscription is the tenant account that you would have for Windows Intune that you integrate with Configuration Manager. And it takes a little while to get one of these set up. So we already have it set up in our environment. So I'll just show you what the process would look like. So if we take this Windows Intune subscription, we go to its properties, you'll see that you can specify a lot of good information that will help out your end user. So on the first page, on the general page, you'll have the collection of users that is allowed to go ahead and enroll their mobile devices. When you're just piloting this, you may not want to have all your users able to enroll their devices. So you might want to have just your administrative staff testing out the solution and verifying that you have all your procedures, your administrative workflows taken care of. Here we have all users, but you can see you can specify the collection you want to go to. You can then specify a company name. So what company is this branded for? So giving the end user some assurances that this is not a phishing site that they're going to, that it's coming from some reliable customer resource, company resource. You have a color scheme. So you can pick the appropriate color scheme that matches your corporate colors. You can put in a privacy documentation here. So when the end user goes to enroll their mobile device, what are the things that IT might be doing to their personal mobile device that they're enrolling? Just to give them some comfort that, yes, IT might be pushing some security policies down or might be allowing me to install some applications. From there, when the end user tries to enroll their device, they might have some issues. So you can specify company contact information. So when that end user is trying to enroll their device or trying to do some management with their device, pick an application, install it, and they have issues, where do they go for help? So they can see a contact name, a contact phone number, a set up an email to the appropriate administrator, go to a website. You can also put in company logos. So you can brand the company portal that we'll show you once we get our devices enrolled. So again, they can have that assurance that this is company related, not some malicious intent by somebody else on their environment. So you can browse in your company logos, bitmaps, and have those displayed in your environment. So you configure how the environment you want to act. Then what you do is go ahead and specify which platforms of devices you want to have. And when you're initially setting up this, we'll give you checkboxes for the four appropriate platforms. Since we're already installed, all you would do now is just go and pick the appropriate platform you want. The nice thing is you can start very small. Maybe I only want to start my piloting with Windows environments. So I'll go ahead and just enable Windows, and then later on come back and enable Android or iOS or Windows Phone, whatever it is. So just go ahead and specify the environments you want. So in this case, Android is just a simple checkbox. That's all I have to do. For iOS, you enable the checkbox, and you also have to go and request an Apple push notification certificate. Because of the fact we're using the Apple MDM protocols that are built into the iOS device, Apple is doing that management. So we have to go to Apple, get a certificate, download it from the Apple website, and then import it into our environment. It's a very simple process. If you look in the background here, you can see up in the ribbon, we have a action, create APN certificate request. You can just click that action, specify a file you want to download to, log in with your Apple ID, request a certificate, download it, and then you just go back to our dialog here and you browse to it. And then you get this response saying the certificate is on file. So we have gone in there and specified the appropriate certificate we need to enable management of iOS devices.
It's worth pointing out, Wally, that that certificate has no cost associated with it. You don't have to have an Apple developer account or anything like that. It's purely an Apple ID needed to download it, correct?
That is correct. Absolutely no cost requirements at all for that. Yep. For Windows. So for Windows environments, again, you just enable the checkbox, what platforms you want to support. Then you have to have a code signing certificate. So as you're side-loading applications, you have to have certificates to help you verify the application is from a trusted resource and that it is allowed to be installed in your environment. So you go ahead and get a code signing certificate and browse it into your environment. And then Windows Phone 8. So on Windows Phone 8, there is a certificate requirement. This is a Symantec certificate you do have to go and purchase for your production environments. But for the piloting testing environments, we have produced a free download trial certificate you can download from the Microsoft website. You would download that support bundle, which includes a certificate. You would sign your, as it shows in the very bottom here, the company portal. So the Windows Phone 8 company portal, which is the application you'll see that would run on your device to find applications or get this support from help desk when you need help. You would sign it with that certificate and you'd import it here. So that's for a test environment that you would happen to have to validate your Windows Phone 8 infrastructure. So the cool thing is you just go pick and choose the platforms you want. If there's a certificate requirement, you go and browse to it, import it in your environment, and you're off and running. You could enable these or disable these after the fact as you deem necessary in your environment. So you can control what platforms your end users are bringing and enrolling into your infrastructure for management with Configuration Manager. Now, once you've done that subscription, a couple of things happen for you. One is we create a distribution point for you, and that distribution point is a cloud-based DP. You see it here. It's given the name of, manage.microsoft.com, and we designate it as a cloud-based DP. So you're always able to tell what DP I'm trying to distribute my content to, whether it's an on-premise DP for my on-premise clients, or it's my Windows Intune cloud-based distribution point, which would be applicable for my mobile devices that I'm managing. So that gets created for you automatically. And then the final piece you have to do to tie this infrastructure together, this cloud-based solution, Windows Intune, with your on-premise solution, is you have to go and create something called a Windows Intune connector. So you'd expand the site configuration folder, you click on servers and site system roles, and here again you see that cloud-based distribution point we install for you automatically, manage.microsoft.com. You would go to your site server computer or some other resource that you want to set up as your Windows Intune connector, and you just add the simple site system role down here called Windows Intune connector. And in essence, the Windows Intune connector is the relay agent taking your administrative actions in the on-premise environment and pushing them up to the cloud service, Windows Intune, to say, these platforms are supported. Here's an application I want this platform to install. Here's a security setting I want to be implemented. It also will retrieve data from these clients. So once you enroll a device, it's going to send in inventory information. It's going to send in status information. That's going to come from the cloud service through the Windows Intune connector down to your Configuration Manager on-premise device environment, so it'll appear with all the rest of your devices you have in your infrastructure. So that's really what the infrastructure looks like. Integrate the cloud service with the on-premise solution with an Intune, Windows Intune subscription, enabling the platforms you want, creating appropriate certificates you need, and then enabling the Windows Intune the Windows Intune connector site system role.
And the Windows Intune connector site system role, the communication from that is all outbound and HTTPS. So there's no inbound connection from the devices into the enterprise.
Correct.
There's nothing actually connecting directly into the corporate network, so you don't have to put that in the DMZ or harden it in any particular way. It just needs access out to the internet.
Yes,
correct?
We're going out to the internet to get this information from Windows Intune. Clients are only talking to the Windows Intune service. Mm-hmm. So you don't have to have any inbound infrastructure set up to allow those devices to connect back to the corporate.
So if you've got System Center Configuration Manager 2012, Service Pack 1 or R2, it's very easy to get this set up and deployed and get access to managing mobile devices.
It is very, very simple to do.
Great. So now we've seen it on the server side of things. Should we switch over to the devices and see what the user experience is around enrolling a device?
Let's enroll a couple of devices.
Okay.
Alrighty, so here you see a Windows RT device running the newest Windows 8.1 operating system, and we want to go ahead and enroll this as a mobile device. The nice thing is that the OMA DM agent, this management agent, is built into the operating system. So it's really, really simple and easy to go ahead and enroll a Windows RT device or a Windows 8.1 device. So from this device, I'm going to go ahead and go to Settings. So I'll click the Settings node, and it brings up my appropriate settings. I'm going to click on Change PC Settings. It'll pop up with our list of settings that we have available to us. We're going to go down to Network, and then we go to a new settings available for us in the network for Windows 8.1, which is Workplace. So workplace settings gives us a couple of things that you had mentioned in your slide, Barton. One of those was the registration process, mm-hmm. and that's what's shown here is the join option, and that will give us a lightweight Active Directory presence mm-hmm. so that this device is known in my corporate infrastructure and then can access corporate resources like SharePoint, internal sites, and so on. But then if I want to manage the device and roll it into this infrastructure for management, I do the turn on option. So let's go ahead and log in. So we'll log in with an account that has been enabled. mbuvacontosodemo.com. And go ahead and click turn on. That will then go ahead and activate the Oma DM agent, get us registered into our infrastructure, and allow us to go ahead and enroll this device, which will then appear through the Windows Intune connector from Windows Intune as a service, and allow us to go ahead, oops.
That's okay, it's actually going to the Active Directory Federation Service sign-in page here. Because we're using ADFS, I'm using my corporate credentials here, it takes us to the ADFS sign-in page rather than just the Intune sign-in page here.
Alrighty.
Okay.
Oh, I know what I did. Okay, I got it. I'm pressing the wrong button there. How about that? No. Okay. Look at that. You only have to supply a password correctly one time, and things work.
It's those complex passwords.
Yes.
It gets every time.
Alrighty, so now it pops up and asks us, hey, do you want to allow your management of your device? So do you want to allow this device to be managed from your corporate infrastructure by IT? And I'll say, I agree. Click turn on. And then momentarily we'll get enrolled. And then this right above where it says turn on, it'll say turn off. So we could very easily unenroll the device from management as well if we determine that we no longer want to have this device managed anymore. Such as I want to hand this device off to one of my kids and replace it with some future device. I don't want to completely wipe it out or reformat it or anything. I just want to go ahead and unroll it and keep it the way it was. And now you can see that it says turn off, which means my device now is turned on. So it is enrolled into management. It will then register. It's registered with Windows Intune. That information is being processed up there. It'll be brought down to the Configuration Manager admin console through the Windows Intune connector, and then we'll see this device appear in our inventory data momentarily.
Okay, and once that device is enrolled, I can then go to the Windows Store and get the company portal application, which will enable me to get access to my corporate applications.
Correct.
And we'll look at that in the second module of this MVA course, when we look at the application deployment, both the user and the IT pro experience. But we'll leave that device there where we've got it enrolled right now. And should we switch over to the iPad and see enrollment on the iOS devices?
And we can do that, yes.
Okay, so let's switch devices.
Very good. Alrighty. Now for an iOS device, the cool thing is you go to the Apple Store and you download our company portal from the Apple Store, and which you've already done on this device. So if I go and click on company portal, this is the company portal application that will appear here momentarily, and this will allow us to go ahead and enroll this device if it's not already enrolled. So we'll go ahead and log in with our appropriate enabled account.
And for this device, the password's in the clipboard, so you don't have to type it on the on-screen keyboard. So you should just be able to select the password field and paste it in.
I don't even know how to paste it in.
Tap and hold, and it will give you the option. So tap and hold within the password field, and hit paste.
Ah, very good.
And then sign in.
This technology.
There you go. So this is doing a similar check of my corporate credentials against ADFS.
Company portal template area not available.
Let's try that again, then. It could be the Wi-Fi went to sleep while it was sitting there waiting.
All right, log in. And there we go. Now our company portal appears. So this is a nice modern application interface you'll see that allow you to browse for applications, get some of that help desk information you want. In fact, you see it down at the bottom, contact IT. Gives you the phone number, it gives you an email address, and it gives you a website you can go to. So that was information we published in our subscription when we set up the Windows Intune subscription from our admin console. But you notice it shows me my devices here. And it says MBoost iPad, it shows a Windows phone, and it shows a Surface device. But you notice on the iPad, it has a little exclamation mark above it. That's indicating that this device that we're sitting on is not currently enrolled in your infrastructure. It's just showing you what you already have. You have a couple other devices enrolled as this user. So if we go ahead and click on MBoost iPad, and it shows you some basic information about this iPad, and we just click down to the bottom, add a device. And it gives us some security information. We can learn more about it. We click the add button up on top. And this is then going to kick us over to our enrollment process. And now you see it's got a management profile. So this management profile is that Apple MDM APM certificate that we imported earlier. It's going to now go ahead and create this and install it on our device so we have that secure communications with the Apple notification service. We'll say install now for that profile. So we're now in the Apple process. So the configuration manager Windows Intune stuff is essentially done. We're in the Apple enrollment process utilizing their service. Just give us a little more information. We click install, generating the appropriate key so we can communicate with the service. And momentarily, they're just enrolling the certificate, installing that profile. Profile has been installed. We click done. And now we're back into our company portal. And now you see the exclamation point has gone away from the MBoost iPad, so it's now a fully enrolled device. So this, just like the Surface, will do the same thing. It will, it's registered with Windows Intune as a cloud service, generating its information up there, its discovery information, its inventory information, storing up there. Our Windows Intune connector from our on-premise environment will go up to the cloud, grab that information, bring it back down to our on-premise solution, and it will appear in our inventory momentarily.
And one of the great things is the fact that IT doesn't need to touch these devices for them to be enrolled. So once IT have set up the connector and the subscription within Configuration Manager, the user just goes and enrolls the devices either through the company portal app from the iTunes store or using the enrollment option built into Windows 8.1. So there's no client that needs to be sideloaded, nothing that needs to be distributed out to the users by the enterprise.
Right, it's just a matter of you control which devices you want to be enrolled, what platforms you control which users can do that, and they go and do all the rest of the work on their own.
Okay, yes. So now we've got the server set up and we've got a couple of devices enrolled. Wally, why don't you take us back to the server console and we can look at how the devices appear there and what we can do with them.
Very good. Console. So now we're back into the administrative console for Configuration Manager. We go to the devices node, and this is where you'll see all the devices in your environment, whether they're discovered resources that are not installed as clients, whether they're Configuration Manager clients, whether they're Windows PCs, whether they're Macintosh clients, Linux, Unix servers you have, or these mobile devices that are enrolled through the Windows Intune Cloud Service. And you can see the basic information on these. If you just go ahead and look at the icon, you'll notice different icons here. So a full-fledged Windows PC that's not installed or is installed as a Configuration Manager client has the computer type icon on it. And the mobile device that are enrolled through Windows Intune has a device icon on it. So very easily you can just view the console and have a quick glance at what are your mobile devices versus what are your on-premise PC devices. So that's very cool that we give you that very quickly. So we have a bunch of devices here. It's 87 of them. I want to go ahead and look at one that we know has been enrolled and has some inventory data. So we'll just do a quick little search. Oh, I got a lot of them that say work on it. So we want work home. So I filtered out a little bit. I guess I could do work home and find it more quickly. If I know, there it is. And you see it does have that icon. So it is a enrolled mobile device. It does say it's a client, just like a full-fledged Windows client would be for an on-premise solution. The site code that we're supporting that it's enrolled into, whether it's a currently active device or not. That's just how frequently it does communicate with the environment, and most of your mobile devices are going to be inactive because they're not going to be communicating on a constant basis like your full Windows devices are. And then one cool thing we have is device ownership, and we'll explain that in just a moment. But let's go look at the properties of this registered device. So we'll go down to properties, just like you would for a traditional Windows device, and you'll see normal things. So you see it got registered with the management point, just like a full-fledged Configuration Manager client. It does heartbeat discovery. You see the date and times of when those appeared. You'll see the edition. It's a Windows device, it's an iOS device, You'll see it's a mobile platform. You'll see the operating system that's running, if it's the NetBIOS name of the device. So here, obviously, is a RT 6, a Windows 8.1 tablet computer. So you see the basic properties that you would expect to see for any type of a computer. We also get inventory information. So if you go to Start and then Resource Explorer, just like you traditionally would see for a Windows device, Configuration Manager Client, go to Hardware, and you'll see the appropriate hardware inventory information that's collected for this Windows 8.1 RT device. You can see its device information, you can see what its disk configuration is, what operating system it's running, you can see applications that have been installed through the management portal, so through Configuration Manager through Windows Intune onto this device. So you get that corporate inventory information that's available to you. So you get all the normal hardware inventory information that you would have. We also do keep hardware inventory history. So if you've had multiple inventory events, just like a full Configuration Manager client would do, you'll have those inventory events so you can look to see what's changed in my device over periods of time and see if, you know, disk is being filled up and I want to track that and so on. So very cool that we get the same type of inventory information you get from a full Windows client.
And you can use it in the same way you would as the information you collect from a full Windows client. So, for instance, building dynamic collections based off inventory attributes or reporting with SQL Server reporting services. Mm-hmm. It's all aggregated into the same database as your on-premise PCs, so the existing tools just extend across the mobile device as well.
Yep. The only difference you would see if you look at the edition that it has or what operating system it's running, you would see those differences. Other than that, it'll appear in your reports and inventory just like any other device you would have.
Why don't you pull up an iPad so we can see the inventory from an iPad and see the similarities and the differences?
All right. Type maybe a little bit better. So here's an iPad, and you see the same type of information across the top as far as the basic properties of it. And again, if we just go look at its properties real quick, you'll see the same stuff you would see from a Windows client. It just tells you it happens to be an iPad as opposed to a Windows computer. So we do tell you the age and edition right there. We tell you it's mobile. You see the PC type, the CPU type. You'll see the operating system. So in this case, it's an iOS 6.1.3 device. So we do show you all that basic information you get from Heartbeat Discovery, just like you saw from the Surface. We also do get inventory as well. So if you go to Start and then Resource Explorer on the iPad, you'll see the same type of information for device inventory, for its memory, for its operating system version, if it had deployed any applications through the Configuration Manager on-premise console, through the Windows Intune subscription service and Windows Intune, you'd have a note up here called Installed It Applications. That would be the applications that have been deployed through the Apple MDM protocol, which is what we're using to communicate with the iOS devices. So, and again, this would appear in your inventory reports and any dashboards you have, just like any other client that you would have. So it fits in seamlessly with all the existing management infrastructure and flow that you have, all your processes. It's all the same for this. So the cool thing is it's a single person, single pane of glass, managing all these different devices with a common workflow that they already have and they know.
Mm-hmm. One thing you mentioned was the ownership attribute. This is the ability to denote a device as being a personal device or a corporate device. Mm-hmm. Do you want to show us in the console where you set that?
Yeah, so by default, this attribute is not enabled in the display. So I added in the column here for device owner. It's just a matter of going in here and selecting the option to display this. But it's a new attribute we have in Configuration Manager 2012. And primarily the reason for it is oftentimes we're talking about end users bringing their own device into your environment. And in those cases, you might want to make things available to the end user, but not force applications on them because it's their own device. But oftentimes corporations will purchase devices for their end users. In that case, IT has much more control or flexibility to force operations down on those devices. So you add in the device owner attribute, and you can just go ahead and see that by default, when a mobile device enrolls, it's listed as a personal device, which means we're not going to push software down to it automatically. We'll make software available, mm-hmm. as we'll see in part two of our session. But there may be devices that you have purchased as the corporation and given to the end user. In that case, I want to mark this device as a corporate-owned device. So all I would do is take the device, I would right-click it, click on Change Ownership, and it gives me the drop-down, changes from a personal to a company device. Very, very simple, easy to do, and now that device changes, I'm sorted on here, so now it's listed as a company device. One of the cool things this does, and we'll show you in part two, is that now I can use this as a requirement rule for application deployment. Now this is a corporate device. I want to go ahead and force my application to be installed, required on this device because it's company owned.
Another great scenario is the idea of company devices, company owned devices. You might have a stronger set of policy because your users are going to be more willing to take a stronger management on company owned device. You can then choose to deploy applications based on that attribute to just those devices. So if you've got an application that is dealing with sensitive data and you want the device more locked down, you can use that company attribute to determine which devices are going to get that app as well.
You can use it as a requirement rule in your application, which we'll show you later on. You could build a collection of just the company-owned devices and target your software just to that collection as well as more security. So yes, very, very easy to manage these devices as BYOD versus company-owned devices.
Okay, great. So we've seen how you set up Windows Intune within Configuration Manager. We've seen the enrollment experience on 8.1 and on iPad. We also do Android and Windows Phone as well. We've also looked at the console and where devices appear there. So that kind of wraps things up for this session. In the second session, we'll move on to looking at the user experience around the applications, both the end user and the IT pro side of things. So do come and check out the second session of this. I've got a few resources here on the slides where you can get more information around Configuration Manager and Windows Intune. So if you want to go and check those out, do so. You can get evaluation versions of Configuration Manager and you can get trial accounts of Windows Intune. So if you want to go and try these out and play with them in a lab environment, you can. So that wraps up session one on user and device management with System Center Configuration Manager and Windows Intune. So make sure you come back and check out the second session, where, as I mentioned, we'll go more into the application delivery side of things. Thanks for watching and listening and joining us with this session.